श्री कृष्ण चैतन्य प्रभु जीव दया कोरी,
श्री कृष्ण चैतन्य प्रभु जीव दया कोरी,
स्वपार्षद श्रेय धाम सहव तरे,
स्वपार्षद श्रेय धाम सहव,
अत्यंत दुर्लभ प्रेम पूरे बारे नाना,
अत्यंत दुर्लभ प्रेमा कोरी बारे दाना,
शिखाया शरणागति भक्त तेरा प्राणा,
शिखाया शरणागति भक्त तेरा प्राणा,
दैन्य आत्मा निवेदन गोकृत्व वरणा,
दैन्य आत्मा निवेदन गोपात्रित्व वारना,
अवश्य रखे कृष्ण विश्वास पालना,
अवश्य रक्षिबे कृष्ण विश्वास पालना,
भक्ति भक्ति अनुकूला मात्र कार्य रसिकारा,
भक्ति अनुकूला मात्र कार्य रसिकारा,
भक्ति प्रतिकूल भाव वर्जनांगिकारा,
भक्ति प्रतिकूल भाव वर्जनांगिकारा,
षडंग शरणागति होए वेद हारा,
षडंग शरणागति होए वेद हारा,
ताहार प्रार्थना सुने श्री नंद कुमार,
आहार प्रार्थना सुने श्री नंदन कुमार,
रूप सनातन पदे गंते तृण कोरी,
रूप सनातन पदे दंते त्रिन कोरी,
भक्ति विनोद पड़े दुपद दोरी,
भक्ति विनोद पड़े दुन पद
दया कोरी, पाशन से धावा सहवतारे
स्वपाशन से धामा सहवतारे
हरे कृष्णा हरे कृष्णा 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 हरे 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 राम हरे राम 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 हरे हरे
हरे कृष्णा हरे कृष्णा 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 हरे 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 राम हरे राम 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 हरे हरे
हरे कृष्णा हरे कृष्णा 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 हरे 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 राम हरे राम 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 हरे हरे
हरे कृष्णा हरे कृष्णा 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 हरे 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 राम हरे राम 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 हरे हरे
कृष्णा हरे कृष्णा 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 हरे 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 राम हरे राम 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 हरे हरे
हरे कृष्णा 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 हरे 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 राम हरे राम 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 हरे हरे
हरे कृष्णा हरे कृष्णा 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 हरे 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 राम 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 हरे हरे
हरे कृष्णा हरे कृष्णा 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 हरे 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 राम 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 हरे हरे
जय जय श्री चैतन्य जय नित्यानंद
जय जय श्री चैतन्य जय नित्यानंद
जय अद्वैत चंद्र जय गौरभक्त वृंद
जय अद्वैत चंद्र जय गौरभक्त वृंद
जय जय श्री चैतन्य जय नित्यानंद
जय श्री चैतन्य जय नित्यानंद
जय अद्वैत चंद्र जय गौरभक्त वृंद
जय अद्वैत चंद्र जय गौरभक्त वृंद
जय श्री चैतन्य जय नित्यानंद
जय श्री चैतन्य जय नित्यानंद
जय अद्वैत चंद्र जय गौरभक्त वृंद
अद्वैत चंद्र जय गौरभक्त वृंद
అనంత కోటి వైష్ణవ వృందకి ఓం అజ్ఞానతిమిరంధస్య జ్ఞానాంజన శలాకయా చక్షువన్నీలితం యేన తస్మై శ్రీ గురవే నమః నమావోం విష్ణుపాదాయ కృష్ణప్రేష్ఠాయ భూతలే శ్రీమతే భక్తివేదాంత స్వామినితి నామినే नमस्ते सारस्वते देवे गौरवाणी प्रचारिणे निर्विशेष शून्यवादी पाश्चात्य देशतारिणे वांछाकल्पतरुभ्यश्च कृपा सिंधुभ्य एव च पतितानां पावनेभ्यो वैष्णवेभ्यो नमो नमः जय श्री कृष्ण चैतन्य प्रभु नित्यानंद श्री अद्वैत गदाधर श्रीवासादि गौरभक्तवृंद हरे कृष्ण 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 हरे 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 राम 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 हरे 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 कृष्णा वी वेलकम ऑल ऑफ यू फॉर द फ्राइडे क्वेश्चन आंसर सेशन फ्रॉम द चैतन्य चरितामृत प्लेंटी ऑफ क्वेश्चंस हैव कम आई विल ट्राई टू आंसर एज मेनी ऑफ देम एज पॉसिबल टुडे हरी द फर्स्ट वन श्रीराम शैटरो प्रभु
श्रीराम प्लैट पाल्टो हरे कृष्ण प्रभु जी पैम हो प्रभु जी विच इज मोर पावरफुल होली नेम और श्रद्धा इन होली नेम as many of times we hear always to chant attentively with faith and devotion. Thus, which is more powerful?
Okay, let us assume that somebody does not have Shraddha in the holy name. So, will the holy name not act at all? Think about it. Yata gadam viryatamam upayuktam yadrachaya ajanatopyatma gunam kurvan mantra udahritaha. This is the verse from Srimad Bhagavatam. Spoken by Vishnudutas to Yamakinkaras. They are saying, yata gadam viryatamam. If one goes to a doctor who gives you blue pills, yellow pills, green pills, different sizes and shapes of tablets, you may not even know the name of the tablet. You may not even know the contents of the tablet. But because doctor is giving it, you just accept it. Then you eat it. If a child eats the tablet or an adult eats the tablet will have its effect in the body. Correct, no? It's not that you have to be very knowledgeable about the tablet. Then we all have experience. Whenever you had a viral fever, you know, you take a 3-day antibiotics course. After 3 days or 4th day, you are out. You are quite normal like anybody. So just as the medicine exerts its potency, whether you know its greatness or not, this is example given in the Bhagavatam. Another example is given of the fire. If a child touches fire or an old man touches fire, the fire is fire. It will exert the same influence, effect. So which means the holy name also, even if you have no Shraddha, you still chant the holy name, it has an effect. Another verse I will tell you. Sanketyam parihasam va stobam helanam eva va vaikunta nama grahanam ashesha agharam viduhu. This verse says that if somebody indirectly chants the holy name, for example, there was some Muslim who was passing stool in the forest. A wild boar was hungry for eating the stool. But the man was sitting for a long time. So it came and attacked him. So when it hit him with the head, you know, so the man was pushed away. So because it used that horn, so that it stabbed him in the belly, so the fellow died. But while dying, he shouted loudly, Haram! He shouted like that. So they always say Haram. Haram means damn it. In English we say, no, like that. So because he said Haram, and inside that Haram there is Ram. So he got liberated completely from all his sinful reactions. Next lifetime he got an opportunity to become a devotee of the Lord. So in this way, the holy name exerted its effect even though he didn't know that the Ram name is being chanted. In fact, Ratnakar, he was not even able to utter the name Ram. He was so sinful. But Narada told him, chant Mara, Mara, because you only know Maro, Maro. Maro, 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 Maro. So the Mara is very natural for you. So he said, Mara, 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 Mara. It became Ram, Ram. He didn't know what is he doing. He just chanted Mara, Mara. And then the Mara, Mara became Ram, Ram. And it had an influence on him. The holy name is so powerful. Even if it is indirectly chanted. Parihasamba. Somebody is joking. Like sometimes we go to the marketplace, we are passing by, people see us with tilak and shika, you know, walking, and then they will say, hey, Hare Krishna is going. So when you go near the shop, hey, Hare Krishna, like that they say, they just joke. They don't intend to very sincerely chant Hare Krishna, they don't say like that. Hey, Hare Krishna, like that they call. But still they get benefit, because what are they uttering? Hare Krishna. One time there was a news criticizing devotees. In the newspaper, there was one paragraph. Somebody took the paper cutting to Bhaksan Sarasi Thakur. Bhaksan Sarasi Thakur immediately took a pen, he underlined, where all, how many Krishnas are there? 8 or 10 Krishna names were there. So he said, very successful, very nice clipping, he said. Why? Because they uttered Krishna names 8 or 10 times in the small article. So he was only counting their chanting of the holy name, even though they might have written the name without much knowledge of Krishna, Shraddha in Krishna. In fact, they are criticizing Krishna also. Still, he counted the name Krishna. So, when Devananda had taken the movie, Dhamma Radham movie, Mit Jaye Gam, you know, and then Hare Krishna, Hare Ram, he had made the song. So many ISKCON devotees became very disturbed. They went to Prabhupada and said, Prabhupada, they are singing our mantra, Hare Krishna, Hare Ram, but then they are taking to drugs and all those things. It will really lead to some bad publicity. Prabhupada said, don't worry. You know, they are anyway chanting Hare Krishna, Hare Ram. They will popularize Krishna. They will popularize Rama. And then he said, and they have come, they will do this tamasha for a short while and they will all be gone. But Hare Krishna, Hare Ram will remain. Prabhupada said, and that became true. So those fellows are gone now. Nobody even talks about them. Although they criticize devotees not knowing actual standard of the devotees. Like once I was going in the train, some boys saw me and from a distance they were saying, Dhamma Radham, they were saying, Hare Krishna, Hare Ram. So I went near, they asked him, what do you mean? He said, hey, I know you people must be drinking, smoking. You do all that, along with that you chant Hare Krishna, Hare Ram. Then I told him, see, our door of our temple is open for you. Come and stay in our ashram for a month. And see, what is because Brahmacharya is living in temple. You can even see the life of Grihasthas. And I told them about the four regulative principles. And what all we follow in ISKCON. If you don't trust us, come and watch. Come and live with us. See our lifestyle. Rise in the morning. See Mangalarti. See the four principles we are following. And after I spoke for about 10 minutes continuously, a dozen Bhagavad Gitas went. Immediately, all his friends took Bhagavad Gita. Except him, everybody took Gita. So anyway, I clarified to him, but others were very inspired and they took it. So in this way, you will see, he was thinking that he can joke about me or criticize about me. He criticized, but the result of his criticism was books went. A dozen Gitas were sold immediately. You will see that. So in this way, some people may criticize Krishna also. Like Shishupal criticized Krishna. And the result was, you know, he was liberated by Krishna's chakra. Kamsa was afraid of Krishna. He was liberated. Shishupal, Kamsa, all these people. Sankityam, Parihasamba, Stobam, Helanam Evva. That he says. Some people, Stobam means some people like musical entertainment. Oh, I like you guys, that tune you all sing. Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna. Krishna, Krishna, Hare, Hare. Hare Rama, Hare Rama. Rama, Rama, Hare, Hare. So there are many videos you will find in our internet, you will find. Many ISKCON devotees in Stockholm, in Germany, in America, London, they go for doing Harinam. Many boys, girls going to college, you know, they come and dance in the Kirtan. But what do you think they like? They like the music. They like the devotee's simplicity. They like the cheerfulness of the devotee. So they come and join. And they just watch that and they also just join. How much knowledge do they have of the holy name? How much Shraddha they may have that you know, Krishna is non-different from the holy name and all that. But they benefit. There are people who came like that and eventually became fixed up devotees. Therefore, holy name itself is powerful. Whether you have Shraddha or not. So this is the first thing you have to understand. And the second thing, one boy came to me and said, Prabhu, I am chanting this holy name for so many years. It doesn't work. You know, in fact, I am developing aversion for it. Now I am not able to continue 16 rounds. I am reducing my rounds. Then I told him, you are offensive. And the more you commit offenses, it is like increasing fever. If you commit offenses to the holy name, by committing one of the 10 offenses, then the holy name is a person. Holy name is not different from Krishna. So, naturally, he will reciprocate with you accordingly. Because you are not a newcomer. For coming newly, one can chant holy name in any way you want. But if you have stayed for a while, it is expected that you chant the holy name with transcendental faith, with sincerity, without any offenses, with innocent heart, pure heart. All that becomes important over a period of time. As you, one example I'll tell you, it will become clear for you. Say there was a very big, you know, rich man. He was a thousands of crores worth company he had. 20,000 crores or something like that. Big company man. So one Hare Krishna devotee used to go to his house for Janmashtami fundraising. He would give just 1,000 rupees he would give. 1,000 or 2,000. This devotee would come back and say, he's a miser. He has got 20,000 crores. And how much is he giving? 1,000, 2,000, peanuts. He is not having any affection for Krishna. He's heartless fellow. But another devotee went, this devotee stopped going to him, another devotee was sent. He went, and that fellow gave 1.5-2 crores for building a Krishna temple somewhere. So, now this devotee was surprised. When I went, he gave 1,000, 2,000. For him, he is giving 2 crores. So, what do you think about that millionaire? Is he a capable man or an important man in giving money? Capable man. So, because this fellow was getting 1,000, 2,000, he was scolding, he's an important man, he doesn't give any money for God, he keeps himself. So, he was criticizing because his way of dealing with him was improper. The other devotee was very nice in dealing with him. So, he became very pleased with the devotee's behavior. So, he naturally opened his treasury to give. Same with the holy name also. In the holy name, if somebody is committing offenses, somebody is offending devotees, somebody is offending guru, somebody is offending, you know, Vaishnavas and scriptures and everything. And then still you ask, Prabhuji, which is greater? Is Shraddha and the holy name greater or holy name greater? Actually, if you don't commit offenses, then you come to access the power of the holy name more and more. That is, your ability to access or your inability to access. Holy name is always potent. Like, you know, the sun is always shining very brilliantly. Now, one boy was sleeping in the room with the windows closed, doors closed, like this. And then father was telling, beta, it's 8 o'clock now, your bus is going to come in 15 minutes. You get up quickly, take a bath. In 15, 20 minutes, you have to catch the bus. Son said, the boy was telling that, no, papa, the sun has not yet risen. It's so pitch dark, why do you want me to get up? Father said, but first you come out of the blanket, you know, and then open the window, open the door, then you will see the sunlight. If you are closing doors, closing window, everything and covering with the blanket, there is no sun. Problem is, sun's problem or your problem? Is it Surya having problem or the boy having problem? Similarly, we put a cover around ourselves and don't access the holy name because of two things, sins and offenses. These two things block our vision of the holy name. Holy name is 100% potent at all times. So, we make ourselves inaccessible to the holy name by our own misdeeds. That's what we have to understand. Read this next one.
Hare Krishna Prabhuji.
Yeah.
I had posted a question in behavioral science, but unfortunately, due to the public paucity of time, it did not got answered. So, once again, putting the question to you. I am working as a legal manager in NBFC company, but currently I am not at all interested in my work and drawn towards achieving the goal of God realization by praying to the Lord and His saints to please associate me somehow with devotees and saints of the Lord so that I can progress and achieve love and devotion of God in this lifetime or in coming future births. How to remain detached from work in this current life of mine and be in Krishna consciousness, but at the same time not neglect my work related activities. All material work is performed due to maintaining body and to serve obligations towards parents to maintain one's living as unlike in spiritual world, which self maintained by the Lord. In material world, you have to maintain yourself and reap fruits according to one's past karmas. I always contemplate in my heart Lord Vishnu as a witness and a sitting with myself every moment while performing my work. Kindly guide me how to maintain balance as work performed in material world is temporary and driven by selfish interests and motives, instead of serving false and temporary masters whose self-interest once over he forgets the servant.
Yeah. So, I understand Srinivas Balasubramanian Prabhu, your heart is more with Krishna consciousness and less with the material world. At the same time, if you have mother, father, wife, children, family, then you have put yourself in a situation where you also have certain family obligations. You are not a brahmachari or a sannyasi living in a monastery. That we should realize. Because according to your position in varnashrama, you have your duties. Like for example, if somebody is a brahmachari has only one duty. He has to serve the spiritual master. According to the order of the Guru, you know, he has to spend his entire day, whatever services Guru has given, he just execute. Whereas one is a grihastha, one should know that the wife and children and mother and father, they are all living entities put in your custody, and you have a responsibility towards them by taking care of them and bringing some grocery for them, building a house, you know, providing them their physical, emotional and all type of needs. So, remembering your duty, you have to act according to your position in society. Imagine if you are a family man, you have wife, children, mother, father. You are sitting in the office and you are thinking of Lord Vishnu and you are thinking that I will go to Matha more, spend more time with saints and say, you know, devotees, and I will hear more classes there, and I am not interested in doing karmi work for bosses who are all selfish fellows. So if that is your attitude, therefore we had one lecture in behavioral science for youth. In that sessions we had attitude towards profession. You can hear that recording. There we spoke about attitude towards profession. You have, first of all, I told you, you should realize your responsibility and duty towards wife, children and family. That's the first one. Then there's the right age for doing everything. Are you 60? If you are 55, 60, you can take vanaprastha and go to temple and tell your wife, see, I gave you sons and daughters, they all are grown up now. They are married and settled now. Now, if you want to come, you also come. We both will go and serve in a matha. If she is not interested, let she be with children and you can go to matha and serve. You have more freedom after you cross 55, 60. But till 50 or so, 25 to 50 is the age of responsibility. You have to do job. So you should know that if I don't do job, I won't get money. If I don't get money, I can't maintain my family members. So therefore, you have to work. That's one reason. Second reason, Krishna says also in this world, even a lion cannot sleep. It has to do some work. Run after a deer or something and catch it. He's a king of the jungle. Even he has to work. What to speak of anybody else? Similarly, everybody in this world has to work hard for their maintenance and everything. Sharira yatra apichate na prasidhye da karmana. Krishna says, it's better for you to do work than be inactive. He says, one has to do the work in this world for survival. So, you may not like your boss or your company and the company work and everything. But, if you do it as a duty, so that you can make some earning to keep your body and soul together, to keep wife and children, mother and father happy. So, you do that. Another third reason, Krishna says, yajñārtāt karmaṇaḥ anyatra lokoyam karma bandhanaḥ tadattam karma kaunteya mukta saṅghas samāchara. He says that yajñārtāt karmaṇaḥ, you can do your work as God's work. Therefore, I was speaking in that same session, I think. What work, you know, if you ask a question to anybody, who are you? I am God's servant. What work you do? I do God's work. How do you do? With sincerity, commitment, dedication, commitment and devotion. I do the work. Then what do you do with the results? I offer it all to Krishna. If I do my company work well, somebody appreciates me, I will say it's all, Krishna has given me the brain, I am able to do it well. So you have two, railway line has two lines. One is material life and one is spiritual life. Both have to go hand in hand because you have a material body right now in which you are seated. So, Prabhupada says, when you have a car which the company has given you, you put water in the radiator, you put air in the tire, you wash the car, clean the car with the hose pipe and everything, isn't it? And after putting petrol and air in the tire and water in the radiator, everything, car is clean, now it's functioning well, you have oiled the car, everything. Then you sit in the car and you drive. Now you don't have to worry about the car much because you have done the maintenance of the car. Now you can focus on the business. Now I have to go to company or I have to go to a client or whatever. So first you have to take care of the car. Imagine you forgot to put water in radiator, air in tire and petrol in the car. You know, you say that I have nothing to give and take with this bodily car. You know, I only have business to do. No, you can't do business without the car. So body is like a car. You have to drink water. You have to breathe the air. You have to put some food. Then the body functions basically. And then you can do, you know, you can focus on Krishna consciousness. Similarly, for keeping bodies all together, we have to work in this world. But eventually, along with your company work, You can also, morning and evening, devote more time to Krishna consciousness along with mother, father, wife, children. One can do that. You are in Mumbai, connect to one of the temples, you know, Hare Krishna Land, Juhu Temple, or Sri Sri Radha Gopinath Temple, Chopari Temple, or Meera Road, there is a temple also there, Radha Giridhari Mandir. Connect to one of the temples, wherever it is nearby to you. Meet the devotees. And if you write a mail to me, I can connect you if you want. voicemedia.pune@gmail.com. You write to me, I will connect you to devotees in whichever place you tell me where you are living, I will connect you. Then they will guide you very closely. Okay? One more question he has asked. Yeah, read it.
Hare Krishna Prabhuji, ISKCON has lineage from Brahma Madhva Gaudiya Sampradaya. Do ISKCON follow the teachings of other acharyas like Sri Raghavendra Swami of Mantralaya, who came under the Madhvacharya's parampara? Can you in future programs please also highlight about the pastimes of Sri Raghavendra Swami, who was ardent devotee and saint following Sri Moolarama and Lord Krishna? Also, kindly request you to clarify whether Sri Raghavendra Swami was incarnation of Vyasadeva and Prahlad Maharaj in their previous lives. Yeah.
Actually, Raghavendra Swami is very popular in Mantralaya in Karnataka. And I have seen a movie on Raghavendra Swami in my school days, I remember. Great devotee. And all of us occasionally get to hear, maybe when there is a birthday or appearance day of Raghavendra Swami, there may be some talk even amongst ISKCON devotees. There are some devotees from Bangalore and Belgaum who belong to Karnataka. So they know a lot about Madhvacharya along with all the other acharyas of the Ashtamat, like Pejavar Math Swami currently, and also they know about Raghavendra Swami. But not all of us are so familiar, knowledgeable. So I suggest you, if you are more interested to hear on such lectures, there is one Govind Prabhu who speaks from Sri Sri Radha Gopinath Temple, Bombay. And there is also one Kamal Lochan Prabhu in Meera Road Temple. You are in Mumbai only. In ISKCON Meera Road, Kamal Lochan Prabhu must have given many lectures on this type of topics. You can check with him. Yeah. Thank you. Next one.
Sanjay from Nizamabad. Why it is said that Maya's army is extremely well equipped? It has the best of ornaments, multitude of soldiers, countless spies and secret agents. Please
explain
it.
I answered it before. You remember this? It is again asked, I think, is it? Okay. Okay, I will give additional answer if you want. If Sanjay Prabhu wants additional answer. You see, what is Maya? Maya is Krishna Shakti. Just like jail. Yes, government's one of the energies. Like Prime Minister has two energies. One is the citizens living in the country. Yes, government. You know, we have a governance for running the society. Then there is also a jail department, which is also Prime Minister's another type of energy. Those who are law abiders live in the country. Those who are law breakers live in the jail. Now, for example, like one boy was telling, I will go on the road, but I will not follow the traffic laws. Even if a signal, red signal falls, I will see it, but I will break the law. Can he do that? No, he can do that. But when he does that, police will stop him, traffic police. So he gives a slap to the police and just kicks him and he goes ahead. What will happen? The police will immediately note the vehicle number and then he's going to complain. And two punishments he will get. One punishment for breaking the law, another one for beating the police, correct, no? Then imagine if some action is taken, he's not accepting that action. Then he'll be put behind the bars, he'll be taken to task by the police. And he tells the police, no, you cannot handcuff me, you can't take me to police station, do what you want. If he keeps a gun and shoots the police, then what will happen? Oh, then commandos will come. See, that is the meaning of government. It starts with traffic police. If you don't align with them, then there's a other big police force. It goes to DSP, then it goes to commandos. Then the whole Indian army will be there behind you. Correct, no? So, now if you say, oh, you are saying that well-equipped and multitude of soldiers, countless spies. Yeah, even in a, I am telling you, practical government. You try to break the law of the state and see what happens. You will see the whole, the defense can be, mechanism of the country can be behind us. Big fellows, who escaped the eyes of the police, like Veerappan stealing sandalwood or Phoolan Devi. People like this, eventually they were caught. It's only a matter of time. They may, for some people, they may take more time. But the point is, just as the police force and commandos are capable people, and the whole government is backing them up because they are acting on behalf of government. Same way, Mayadevi is acting on behalf of Krishna. Especially, it's a thankless task of Maya to keep those conditioned souls who are unsurrendered and rebellious and to give them purification treatment and eventually bring them to sanity. That you have to surrender either to Krishna or to Maya. You can't do, you can't be independent here. Like scientists are people who don't want sufferings from Maya, but they will not surrender to Krishna. You understand what I am saying? Like if a child goes to school, he will not do homework, but teacher should not give punishment also. How is it possible? He will not take punishment also, but he will not do homework also. Is it possible? Same way, scientists are people who say, oh, if it is too hot, we will create an air conditioner for you. Correct? No? If it is too cold, we will create a heat pump for you. Correct? No? Oh, if you are feeling some pain due to wound, we will give you some painkiller. So they are trying to suppress all your pains without teaching you to surrender to God. But scriptures tell you very politely, sir, all these sufferings are due to your karma. Better you surrender to Lord. You surrender to Lord and you are free from karma. And your karma is burnt. So therefore, Maya's army is ultimately Krishna's army only. Maya is Krishna's dasi. She will act as per Krishna's order. Maya adhyakshena prakritihi suyate sacharacharam 9.10 Bhagavad Gita. And Brahma Samhita also. Srishtisthiti pralaya sadhana shakti reka chaye vayasya bhuvanani vibharti Durga. He says, no? So Durga is chaye eva. Chaya eva means when you move the fingers, the chaya also moves accordingly. Shadow. Similarly, when Krishna orders Devi, Maya Devi, accordingly she acts. So because she is Krishna's energy, she is very mighty, powerful. Next.
Ajay Gupta from Mumbai. Hare Krishna Prabhuji. Who was the first person to see Lord Krishna? And how and who had made the first picture or photos of Lord Krishna?
The first person must be Radharani, because Radharani expanded from Krishna only. Correct, no? As soon as Radharani must have come, expanded from Krishna, she must have offered obeisances to Krishna. And then all the other jivas subsequently must have offered obeisances. Anyway, don't think that Krishna appeared 5,000 years ago. The photos were made and everything. Even in Satya Yuga, there were Krishna temples. Prabhupada says, I have shown the reference. If you haven't seen it, I'll show you again. So, so in the Srimad Bhagavatam 4th canto, okay, there is one verse called Ari Radheshu Krishnam Acharat Tapa Uttama. Okay, I got it. So in this verse, see, this verse says, Trikshur Yadavagnanta Vurdvareta Jitan Laha Ari Radheshu Krishnam Acharat Tapa Uttamam. I'll show you the second part, I'll show you. Read this one.
There are many fools who claim that worship of Krishna began only about 5,000 years ago after the appearance of Lord Krishna in India. But this is not a fact. Prithu Maharaj worshipped Krishna millions of years ago. For Prithu happened to be a descendant of the family of Maharaj Dhruva, who reigned for 36,000 years during the Satyuga age. Unless his total lifespan was 100,000 years, how could Dhruva Maharaj reign over the world for 36,000 years? The point is that Krishna worship existed at the beginning of creation and has continued to exist throughout Satyuga Treta Yuga and Dwapar Yuga, and now it is continuing in Kali Yuga. As stated in Bhagavad Gita, Krishna appears not only in this millennium of Brahma's life, but in every millennium. Therefore, worship of Krishna is conducted in all millenniums. It is not that Krishna worship began only when Krishna appeared on this planet 5000 years ago. This is a foolish conclusion. That is not substantiated by Vedic literatures.
Yeah. Okay. We saw this. So we have to know it has been there since the dawn of creation. Okay. Go to the next one.
Megha Mataji from Germany.
Oh, sorry.
Hare Krishna Prabhuji, we have a Jagannath Baldev and Subhadramaya along with small Gopals are in our altar. Only morning, me and my Prabhu offer aarti to them and whatever we cook that we offer three times. So, I wish to know what are minimum standards of deity's care a household should do. And one more thing, my daughter is 15 months old, many times she puts Lord paraphernalia in her mouth when my offering or dressing Lord. I feel so bad, but she don't understand. So what I should do?
She's an innocent child. A small child. Lord is not going to take much offense by a child's innocent putting some item to be used for dressing of the Lord, which she is taking and putting in her mouth. At the same time, you being grown up and mature, and you are aware of devotional service, you can do your best to ensure that, for example, you have kept a bhoga plate which is being offered to Jagannath and child goes and puts the hand in that. So what you can do? Have the altar very high and have a table high so child cannot reach it. If you are keeping the Jagannath just in a small table like this and you are putting bhoga here, easily child can come and pick up. So you can find out ways to keep the bhoga away from the child. Child cannot eat it in between. So there won't be any offense. So we can, since you are a devotee or a grown-up devotee, you can actually make ways by which you will be careful. Once a child grows up, child will also become, daughter will become more mature also as she grows up. But from our side, we should consciously make efforts to avoid anything like that, because the Lord is watching. It's a seva aparadha, we call it. Some mistake happens like that. But if it repeatedly happens, then the Lord will feel that this person is inattentive in my service. This person doesn't care any less for my service. So then it becomes a seventh offense against the holy name. But if you take care, you make conscious effort to avoid it, you can avoid it. Yeah, next.
Sri Ram Patro from Pune. Hare Krishna Prabhuji, Pam Ho. Prabhuji, we as a devotee of ISKCON, are we Gaudiyas or Vaishnavas? And what is the difference? Your servant Sri Ram.
Those who are worshippers of any Vishnu Tattva, like Sita Ram, Lakshmi Narayan, Radha Krishna, they are called Vaishnavas. Those who are worshippers of Krishna, like our Vallabha Sampradaya, they are worshippers of Krishna. Then you are called Karshnas. Those who are worshippers of Radharani, along with Krishna, and they approach Krishna through Radharani, they always know that Hare, then Krishna. So they are called Gaudiyas. So we are actually worshippers of Hare Krishna, Radha Krishna, and we approach Krishna, understanding Radharani to be the best devotee, and through her we give all our offerings to Krishna. Because according to our acharyas, Krishna, is not easily approachable by us directly. Mahatmanasu mam partha daivim prakritim ashritah. That devi is my mother, Radha, Radhika. So through Radhika, those approach, they are called Gaudiyas. Yeah. And also, such Gaudiyas, they are followers of Lord Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, who teaches us how to become proper Radha and Radha Krishna devotees. Yeah. Next.
Harsh Prabhu from Lucknow. Hare Krishna Prabhuji, I have a few questions. Prabhuji, if a non-devotee person recites Bhagavad Gita or Srimad Bhagavatam Shlok, at the last moment of his life, will he go back home, back to Godhead, according to Bhagavad Gita 8.5 and 8.6? It is a very annoying...
See, I'll answer this first. Antakale cha mameva smaran muktva kalevaram yaprayati samadbhavam yati nastyatra samshayaha So sometimes a man is dying, about to die. So people recite Bhagavad Gita for him. And then they try to remind him of Krishna. But sometimes the old man who is about to die, because all his life he has watched cricket, he has been reading newspaper, talking politics. Suddenly in the last minute he cannot become very Krishna conscious. It's difficult for them. Because you can't bend a bamboo when it is dry. And a bamboo is green, you can bend it. So we have seen people who are very old, who are unable to take up Krishna consciousness suddenly. Worst come worst, what you can do? After they die, they put tulasi in the mouth, little Ganga gel, some garland offered to Lord. So those spiritual items will benefit him to get the body in a devotee's family in the next life, where he will be given one opportunity to become a devotee. Therefore, we do all that. Now, even if a person, you say that at the last moment of his life, he suddenly recited Bhagavad Gita and he left his body. He's a non-devotee. What will happen to him? So, Lord Krishna is not a mechanical machine or something like that. In Antakalacha, he said, so he did Antakalacha, so take him back to Godhead. No. Actually, because he has uttered the Gita verse or something, he will be given a chance to become a proper devotee. He will get birth in a area where there is a Vishnu temple nearby. His home will be in the same lane where the temple is there. Or he'll be born in a Brahmana family or a Vaishya family, where he will get, you know, abundant facilities for becoming Krishna conscious. Then he may further progress from there. Actually, who will go back to Godhead? Why, a person, even all your life, you have been Krishna conscious, chanting 16 rounds, following four rites, entering services, having a earnestness and eagerness to attain Krishna. At the time of death, even if you are in coma, you didn't think of Krishna, no problem. The Varahadev says in the third Charama Shloka, I will show you that. See what he says here. So here in this two-line verse says, Yadi vatadi dosheṇa madbhakto mam na cha smaret. At the time of death, if somebody has a vata, you know vata? Due to vata dosh, a person is in coma state, or he is due to kapha dosh, his throat is choked, like this, he's not choking. Madbhakto mam na cha smaret. My bhakta is not able to remember me. Aham smarami madbhaktah nayami paramam gatim. I will remember my devotee and I will take home back to Godhead. So the 8.5 verses which Krishna says is not applicable here. You see, he is not remembering the Lord at the time of death. But Lord is not a foolish man who is sticking to one typical stereotyped formula. Hey, you are not following 8.5. 99% of the time in your life you served me. Last time you forgot, so you have to come again. Will he do that? So Lord is an intelligent person. He knows all his life he gave his body, mind and words. Now he's in coma, I will take him back. Like that the Lord is saying, Varaha Puran. So one boy was asking me, you know, sir, I will, all my life I will enjoy sense gratification. Eat, drink and be merry. And then I will take a gun when I am 75 or 80. Hare Krishna! Like that I will shoot. Anta Kalacha Mama is done. Will I go back? You think you can cheat God? If you try to cheat God, you yourself will be cheated. Jhutam chalayatam asmi. Krishna says that. Anybody who tries to cheat me, I will thoroughly cheat them. He says that. Go ahead, second question.
It is very annoying argument wherein some people say that Krishna was just a powerful personality but not supreme personality of Godhead. And to support their statement, they quote Bhagavad Gita 4.5 which says, both you and I have passed many, many births. Those people say, look, Krishna also has to take so many births. Kindly explain in this context.
This reveals their foolishness. Abhajananti mam mudha. Mudha means nipat murkh. Because they are only taking one part of the verse. What is this verse they are talking about? Bahuni me vyatitani janmani tavacharjuna thanyaham veda sarvani natvam veta parantapa. Krishna is telling Arjuna, many, many births you and I have appeared in this world. I remember all of them. Tanyaham Veda Sarvani. Natvam Veta Parantapa. But you cannot know. Why? Arjuna asked why. Because you are a jiva, I am God. I am God, I can know. And you cannot know, you are a jiva. When you change the body, you forget. Right now you are in one body. When you die, take another body. You will not remember this life. Then you go to second, third, fourth, fifth. So many bodies. You cannot remember. And I came in this world million years ago, Krishna says. And I gave knowledge to whom? Vivaswan. I gave the knowledge. Still I remember. Why? Because I don't change body like you. You change body, I don't change body. So you should tell your friends that, hey fool, what are you thinking? Do you think Krishna changes body? Krishna's body is Sachidananda Vigraha. You know, Ishwaraha Parama Krishna, Sachidananda Vigraha. Your body was a baby, eventually become a youth, it became old man, your tooth are gone, your hair becomes white hair, your body gets wrinkles, you can't pass stool and urine at the time of death, you have a digestion problem, your kidney is failing, your brain is failing. That is your body. Krishna's body is not like that. Have you ever seen Krishna as an old man? Tell me. Adyam Purana Purusham Navayavanam Cha. He is called as Adyam. He is the Adipurusha. And Purana Purusham. Purana means very, very old. Who is the oldest of all, yet he is youngest like a 16-year-old boy. Adyam Purana Purusham Navayavanam Cha, he says. Because he doesn't change bodies like we change. He always comes in his self same body. Sambhavami Atma Mayaya, he says. He's saying that Swamadishtaya, I freely come, just like the sun rises in the east. You know, are you bringing the sun up? And the sun sets in the west. Can you stop the sun from setting? Similarly, you ask your friend, you are talking about Krishna coming in many births, but what knowledge do you have about Krishna? You are a fool. Because his birth and your birth are like earth and sky difference. Your birth is like you are born, you die. He never dies. He appears like a sun in the east and he sets like a sun in the west. So, people who argue, this is called Ardha Kukuta Nyaya. Ardha Kukuta Nyaya means you don't want to feed the hen on the mouth side. You only want the egg on the back side. You cut the hen into two, then the hen will stop giving you egg. Similarly, any shloka, you cut it into two. Sarvadharman Parityajya Krishna said, so we are all going to give up all religious principles and go to hell. Is that what he says? Second part he says, Mamekam Sharanam Braja, you surrender unto me, he says. That people don't know. Karmanneva Adhikaraste. Krishna has told that everybody work hard like a donkey. The whole world is working like a donkey. You can see that. But they don't know the second line. What is it? Mafaleshu Kadachana. But offer your fruits to me. That nobody knows. So your friends are also catching only the first part of the sloka. Aparam bhavato janma. Chare, bahunime vatitani janmani. Actually, they are envious of Krishna. You know that. In this world, people are so envious. Hey, he is having so many gopis. For me, no, one girl also doesn't want to look at me. Therefore, they are envious of him. And they are envious that he is God. And they have to be servant. Because of that envy only, they have come here. You understand that? Yeah. Read the next one.
Prabhuji, Harsh from Lucknow. Prabhuji, in Hari Bhakti Vilas, a verse quoted from Skanda Puran says, Krishna stays far away from anyone who eats eggplant. But as we know, Srila Prabhupada loved to eat fried eggplant. How do we reconcile this?
Yeah, eggplant is this cabbage. Is eggplant cabbage? You know what is eggplant? Cauliflower? Is it cauliflower or no? What is eggplant? Just find out what is eggplant. Brinjal. Correct. See, sometimes in Bengal they say brinjal. Correct, it's brinjal it is. See, some of the vegetables are having tamasic qualities. For example, tamarind. You know tamarind? What is imli? Or brinjal. They say baingan is begun. They say like that. Why? Because it is tamasic. So now when Hari Bhakti Vilas in Skanda Purana is quoted there, say it says that, you know, because if you eat eggplant, you'll become very dull, you will become very lethargic, and due to which you cannot come to Sattva Guna. And because you cannot be in Sattva Guna, naturally what will happen to you? you will stay far away from Krishna. Correct, no? But that is not applicable to great personalities like Prabhupada or Shiva. For example, if you eat poison, you will die. We can say, no? But Shiva is drinking poison. Is he dying? Why? Why is it not applicable to him? He is able to keep the poison in the throat. Nothing happens to him. Correct, no? For example, if you try to meddle with one girl, you will be finished. Your whole life will be destroyed. You can see Krishna is dancing with thousands and thousands of gopis. And he can maintain a spiritual relationship with them. He is dancing with the spiritual bodies. Can you and I do that? Correct, no? So, one should know that there are tejiya samna doshaya, it is said. Like Srila Prabhupada is an acharya. Even if he eats a tamasic item, that tamasic item is called as tamasic how? That you should understand it. For example, if I eat onion garlic, the power of the tamasic sabji makes my consciousness dull because I am sufficiently not Krishna conscious. Already I am dull, so the tamasic item goes inside and makes me more dull. Whereas somebody very exalted, they have the ability to digest the tamasic sabjis and still not get affected. One example I'll tell you. There was Vatapi and Yelavala. Yelavala and Vatapi, there were two asuras. And these asuras made a program to kill all the rishis and munis. So in those days, there were some rishis also who were eating meat, but they had the ability to digest. So this fellow, who was that rishi who went to Vatapi Ilvala's place, being invited for lunch. So they used to offer some meat on their plate. But what was the meat they offered? Ilvala will cut Vatapi to pieces, his body, and cook it and offer. And after the sage would eat, so he would say, Vatapi, come out, he would say. And Vatapi would break open the belly and come out. And the sage will die. Like that. So for some people, they said, we are feeding you meat. For some people, they didn't say it's meat. They cooked it just like some made of some chapati kind of item or something. When the sages ate, many sages died like this. They cheated the sages like this. So once Agastya went, Agastya knew that these two fellows are doing this kind of thing. He said, I will eat in your home today. So the Vatapi was cut and made, cooked. So he ate Vatapi and he went to bed. And then Nilavala was calling, Vatapi, come out, he said. Like that, he said. And then he was wondering, Nilavala, what happened, Vatapi, he said. Vatapi jirno bhavet, he said. Your Vatapi is finished now today. So he has the ability to digest Vatapi also. So, therefore you should know who is who. You should know. Great acharyas like Prabhupada, he may eat a plant and still he can be at Krishna's lotus feet. Because they are all spontaneous devotees. Once a person comes to Raghunatha Bhakti. Another example I'll tell you. When once Prabhupada came to Pune, there was one house. One big millionaire wanted to help ISKCON in getting a place in Pune in those days when temple was not here. So Prabhupada and some 5-6 devotees had come. It was a 3-day program Prabhupada had in his house, morning, evening, lectures and all. But the first day night itself, they had cooked a big feast. And all the devotees ate. Next day morning, Prabhupada got up at 4:30, Prabhupada came for Mangalarati. All the devotees came with Prabhupada were sleeping in the room. Prabhupada told the leader, hey, where are they? Get them up. Slowly, slowly, they all got ready and came by 6:30. Prabhupada asked, why are they late? They said, Prabhupada, the dinner was very opulent and very heavy. So devotees got very dull. Prabhupada said, pack up our luggage. We are going back to Bombay today only. Just now we are going. But this is Prabhupada, but 3-day program? He said, no. Because the devotees are not sufficiently advanced to digest this food. Because this person is not a devotee. He is cooking with some people, non-devotees, and we are trying to offer it to Krishna. But this food will spoil the consciousness of these devotees. So better go back to Bombay. So they went back to Bombay. But then the food is same food only Prabhupada ate, but he got up in the morning. How? Because that did not affect his consciousness. That's how we can understand. Go ahead.
Mahacharya Ramanuja Dasa from Bangalore. Which and where is the verse of ignorance covering raga, admits, etc. You are saying.
Yeah. I will show you. Yeah. I'll show you the verse. This is the verse. We'll recite that verse. Sasarja agriyanta tamishram atatamishram madhikrit mahamoham cha moham cha tamascha jnana vrittayah 3.12.2. Read the translation.
Brahma first created the nascent engagements like self-deception, the sense of death, anger after frustration, the sense of false worship, ownership, and the illusory bodily conception or forgetfulness of one's real identity.
Yeah, that is the verse I was talking about. Yeah. Okay, next. I'll read the next one.
Next one. Rajesh Sridhar from Bangalore. Prabhuji, in this week's class, you mentioned that devotees like Hanuman worship Sita and Ram together. Likewise, Radha Krishna and Lakshmi Narayan. Sorry, I am confused after hearing that we should not worship Goddess Lakshmi separately. Please, can you explain the position of shlokas on Goddess Lakshmi composed by sages like Lakshmi Sahasranamam, Agastya Muni, Kanakadhara Stotram, Sripad Sankaracharya and many others? Are they allowed to be chanted? A lot of Divyadesam temples in South India have Lakshmi deity separately from the Narayan deity, and we pray there. Please, can you clarify on this? Yeah. Sorry if I understood it wrong.
See, even in our Pune, ISKCON Pune temple, when we are entering the Balaji temple behind our Radha Vrindavanachandra temple, on either side, Jai Vijay are standing. So we take their permission first before we go in. And at the top, Lakshmi is sitting with two elephants doing Abhishek for her. So we take the mother's permission before meeting the father. Because as I told you, we are Gaudiyas, we actually take permission and blessing of Radharani before we can serve Krishna. So whenever I go to Balaji temple, the first thing I do is touch the feet of Jai Vijay and then pray to Mother Lakshmi. Mata samasta jagatam madukaita bhare vaksho viharini manohara divyamurte Shri Swamini Shrita Jana Priyadana Shile Shri Venkatesha Dayite Tavasuprabhatam Aravindalochane Bhavatu Prasanna Mukha Chandramandale Vidishankare Indra Vanita Abhirarchite Prashashaila Nata Dayite Dayanide Ishanam Jagatosya Venkatapater Vishnu Parampre Yasim Tat Bhakshatala Nityavasa Rasikam Takshanti Samvardhinim Padmalankrita Pani Pallava Yugam Padmasanastam Shriyam Vatsalyadi Gunojvalam Bhagavatim Vande Jagan Mataram. So I used to recite these verses. Now, if you see these verses of glorification of Lakshmi, is never separated from Lord Venkatesha. Yeah. Ishanam Jagatosya Venkatapater Vishnu Param Prayasim. You are Venkatachalapati is very dear beloved. So when you look at Lakshmi and glorify her in relation to her Lord, pray to her, I am going to meet your Lord. Please bless me and empower me to take my darshan properly. Then it is perfectly in line with what we were talking, worshipping Lakshmi Narayan together. Correct, no? On the other hand, people who keep Lakshmi photo or a murti in their shops and all, with lot of gold coins pouring down, they never pray to Lakshmi in relation to Narayana. They basically think that this personality will give me a lot of gold coins. Isn't it? Only for metal benefits they keep. That is what we were condemning. Now, Ravana did not take Sita to pray to Sita, oh mother, please connect me to Ram. I want to become a devotee of Ram. No. He wanted to exploit her. So, when one worships, keeps Lakshmi or Sita alone, separated from Ram, Prabhupada said, a crying Sita in the hands of Ravana can never make Ravana happy. A smiling Sita standing next to Ram can make the whole world happy, he says. So, Sita will be happy only when you worship her with Ram. Similarly, going to Balaji temple, if you see, even in other Vishnu temples in South India, Tayar, Sannidhi, they will say, you go to Lakshmi, pray to her, and then you take darshan of Narayana. That's perfectly all right. We are not worshipping only her. After worshipping her, we are worshipping Narayana also. Yeah. Next.
Abhishek Singh from Gurugram. On the context of some verses, you said that Mayavadis are still better than Buddhists because they accept Vedas, but on the other hand,
Some Mayavadis are offensive, who think that Krishna is in Maya, and they go to hell. Being offensive to Krishna will be worse than non-offensive, which are Buddhist, because they do not know about Vedas. How to know which one is good?
Yeah, actually, Prabhupada explains about this. He says that impersonalists, not there are four types of impersonalists. The Shukadev and Chatushkumaras, they are good impersonalists. Why? Actually, they were impersonalists. They worshipped Krishna and then they became devotees. Then there is another type of impersonalist who respects Krishna and he requests Krishna to give him moksha, to relax in Brahma Jyoti, Shanti, Shanti, Shanti. So they use Bhakti Yoga to go to Brahma Jyoti. With sanction of Krishna, they go to Brahman and get moksha. But they don't want to become devotees, those Brahmavadis. Then the other two Brahmavadis are offensive. They are called Mayavadis. One Mayavadi thinks that Krishna has a body made of flesh and bones like ours. They think like that. That is offender, Mayavadi Krishna Paradi. So he goes to hell. Then there is a fourth type of Mayavadi who does not connect with Krishna at all. Doesn't take shelter of Bhakti Yoga at all. He thinks by my own strength, Svavimukta Maninaha, he imagines himself to be liberated. So he goes to Brahman, he falls down. Aruhya Kritrena Parampadam Tataha Patantiyado Anadrata Vishmadangra, he says. So out of these four, two are offensive and two are not. So therefore we don't know. But all four of them accept the Vedas at the basis. Whereas the Buddhists don't accept the Vedas. So from that point of view, Brahmavadis are better than voidists. Prabhupada said, in this world, there is no void anywhere except in the head of the voidist, he said. Because they have no brain to understand God's greatness. So the voidists are atheists. So such kind of atheism is more condemnable than impersonalism. But when I told that point, what is the meaning of that, I will tell you. At least these people are outright atheists, Buddhists. Whereas impersonalists sometimes take shelter of Bhakti Yoga because they want to use Bhakti to get moksha. That may be misleading, we said. But otherwise, anyone who accepts the Vedas is far, far superior to one who rejects the Vedas. Correct, no? Yeah. Go ahead.
Anonymous, yeah. From Vishakhapatnam. Prabhuji, can you please tell if Mayavad is so much misleading and very harmful, then to bring back people to Buddhism, why only this philosophy was chosen by Krishna and asked Shiva to do it? Krishna can directly send Ramanujacharya and most of the people can become Vaishnavas. Just like now, so many people are atheists and ISKCON is preaching to them and many of them are able to understand and are becoming devotees.
Actually, you may not know, at a time when the whole country was Buddhist, and Buddha had told Nindasi Vedam, they had rejected the Vedas for one reason. Because Brahmanas are misusing the Vedas and conducting Gomedhyagna, Ashwamedhyagna and eating meat at that time. So Buddha saw that Brahmanas are misleading the masses and they are the leaders of society. So he told the people, don't follow the Brahmanas. But then the people told, but Brahmanas are teaching us Vedas, don't follow the Vedas, he said. Then whom to follow? You follow me, he said. Buddham Sharanam Gacchami, Sangam Sharanam Gacchami. Then they asked, okay, I'll follow you. Then what should we do? He said, Ahimsa Paramo Dharma. He said, Ahimsa is the topmost religion. So if you are Ahimsak, then he gave right thought, right speech, right action. 8 things he gave and all that. He spoke about suffering, arising. He said there are fourfold truths. He said, in this world there is suffering. And suffering comes from desire. And the desire is the root cause of all evil. And the desire should be abandoned. So he taught like that, these things. So Buddha, that's all he taught. And now in ISKCON, if you see, for us, Ahimsa is a ABC in ISKCON. There is much more we do beyond Ahimsa, isn't it? So at that time, it was very difficult to bring people back to Vedic life because people, anybody you tell them to accept the Vedas, they will say, no, Buddha has told us, we will not accept. Even now you go to Buddhists, try to make them devotees, just see how difficult it is. You will understand it. Because they are Shunyavadis. It's very, very rare for a Buddhist to become a Hare Krishna. There may be some handful, but very rare. Samahatma Sudurlabha. It's like that. So Shankaracharya had to introduce the Vedas, reintroduce. So what he did very intelligently, he introduced the lowest understanding of the absolute truth, which is the one Brahmeti, Paramatmeti, Bhagavan iti shadite. Bhagavan they will not accept immediately. Paramatma also has a form they won't accept. But the Brahman seems very close to voidism. Huh? These guys are saying Nirvana, go beyond samsara. And Shankara also said, yes, yes, you go beyond samsara, you attain Nirvana, along with Nirvana, you accept the Brahman also, impersonal Brahman. Even scientists accept that there is some powerful energy, powerful intelligence which is governing the universe. Even Einstein says that. If you see in Google, you will find. Many scientists accept that God is some very powerful energy. So therefore, he introduced it. It's very easy for people to accept. Yeah, next. But if you accepted bhakti directly, even now, if you see, ISKCON is introducing bhakti, but there are many people, as soon as they hear about bhakti to Krishna, surrender to Krishna, they run away. They don't want to accept even now. How much percentage of the world is willing to open their hearts to accepting bhakti? We are having some 800 centers worldwide, but the number of devotees all over the world will be maximum 2 million, 1 million, 2 million only. 2 million means 20 lakhs. Where is 20 lakhs in relation to 7 billion or 8 billion population? It's a small fraction. Yes.
Anjaney Sharma from Bangalore. Yeah. I have heard Vyasadeva personally came and glorified Vedanta Sutra commentary of Shankaracharya and didn't come for Ramanuja. Why?
But who said that? Shankaracharya only will say that. That is very important, no? You have to give me, whenever you talk such things, you have to give me the evidence where you got this truth from. Do you know Madhavacharya personally met Vedavyas? Do you know that? You know, he went to the Badrikashram where Vyasadeva lives in a gupha. Even now, he went and met him. So in this way, whenever you hear such things, you have to get the reference. Then we can talk more. For example, the Govinda Bhashya, which was written by Baladeva Vidyabhushan, he didn't write it. This was dictated by Lord Govinda, personally. He dictated to him Vedanta Sutra commentary and he wrote it down as it is. And all the panditas there were defeated in that place when he presented the Govinda Bhashya commentary. So, in the same manner, Shripad Ramanucharya, Madhvacharya, our Baladeva Vidyabhushan, they all have written commentaries and they all have a connection to the Supreme Lord, and there are people who talk about it. So, somebody may talk about Shankara in the same manner. Everybody has a connection. You can talk about it. Yeah, yes.
Ratin Singh. Shankaracharya composed Jagannath Ashtakam, Gita Mahatmya, and also told Bhajagovindam, Mudamate. So why his followers didn't understand the actual thing? We are servants of Lord, in spite of all these hints by Shankaracharya.
Shankaracharya is called as a covered personalist. Inside his personalist, outside he is impersonalist. So, it requires one himself to be a devotee to recognize Shankara's position. For example, Lord Shiva, externally he looks like living in Smashan. You know, he is wearing basma, he is having snake, having jata, he looks like an avadhuta. Many people look, he is very ghastly looking. Even the ghosts and spirits think that, hey, he is like one of us, they think. But little do they know, he is a Vaishnava devotee. Vaishnava naam. When Prabhupada went to the West also, hippies couldn't recognize him. They thought of him to be ordinary. But eventually they understood that, oh, he is a Mahatma devotee. So just as Shiva can be seen externally, and Vaishnava sees Shiva internally by seeing him as a devotee. Same with Shankara also. He is also Shiva only. Shiva coming as an avatar. So he externally he is preaching Mayavad to those who don't want to surrender to the Lord, who are envious of the Lord. Those who are envious of the Lord, they want to compete with the Lord and claim that I am only Brahman, I am Supreme Brahman, I am God. For them, he is preaching externally. But those who are, even for his mother, at the time of her death, Shankaracharya showed her Shiva Tandavam. When she saw the Shiva's Tandavam, she got frightened. She said, beta, I am going to leave my body and it's very frightening. This is a Tandav which Shiva does at the time of Pralaya. So then he said, don't worry, now I will give you another vision. So he gave her vision of Vishnu and Vaikuntha and told his mother, I will send you to Vaikuntha now. So he sent his mother to Vaikuntha. And he also wrote all these books which you said. Even Lord Chaitanya has sung Jagannath Ashtakam by Shankara. So therefore people say it is Jagannath Ashtakam Kritam. It's the writer is Shankara and it has emanated from the lips of Chaitanya, like that they say. So Chaitanya also recognized Shankara as internally a devotee called covert personalist, he said. Yes. Like even you all of you, when you go to office, you wear coat suit, boot tie, you don't look like a devotee. When you come to temple, you come with dhoti, kurta, you're chanting, dancing. You don't chant, dance in the company. Correct, no? You play two different roles. Same thing he did. Yes.
Ajay Gupta, once again from Mumbai. Prabhuji, can you explain some of the 4 lakh different types of human beings from total 8.4 million living entities?
Yeah, that is the verse. I'll just show you the verse. Yeah, this is the Padma Purana verse, which answers your question. See, this is the verse. Here only one is quoted. Okay, I'll show you the full verse also is possible to, you can. This is the verse. Jalajanavalakshani stavara lakshavimshati. And then he says, Kramayo rudra sankhyaka pakshinam dashalakshani. See, it says 8.4 million species and the division. If you want to know, this is a journey of self-discovery. Chapter number 3, in that book you will get it, okay? It's from Padma Purana verse, Prabhupada quotes that. Yeah? 400,000, some of the, 400,000 means 400,000 levels of consciousness. Different type of human beings, yeah. Yeah, there are 400,000 levels of human beings. The lowest human being is almost like an animal. And the highest human being is a pure devotee. And lesser than pure devotees are the demigods. And lesser than demigods are the sattvic sadguna people and all. Those who are living in, you know, bhuvaha, swaha, maha, janaha, tapaha, satyam. We say, no? So, satyaloka onward, the gradations of human being starts. And in bhumi, what we have? In the those who are sattvic, they are higher gradation. Rajasik are little lesser. Tamasik are even more lesser. And in that also, those who come in the 4 categories, Brahman, Kshatriya, Vaishya, Shudra, they are more evolved. Outside that, dog eaters, and cow eaters, they are all, Prabhupada says, 6th class, 8th class, 10th class, 20th class, like that he says. There are various levels of humans, yeah. Yes. Go ahead.
Madhavi Mataji from Hyderabad. Prabhuji, thank you very much for your enlightening classes. In the current section of Sarvabhum Bhattacharya's Liberation, there is a discussion about how we should avoid even seeing the face of Mayavadi. However, in the Bhagavad Gita, it is advised that one should evolve to the stage of seeing every living being equally by relating to the Paramatma component residing within them. How to reconcile between these two, which apparently seem to be contradicting?
How to reconcile? When you see a tiger, you know, you will take care the tiger doesn't eat you, correct, no? From a distance, you respect. You don't say, Pandita Samadarshana, I see tiger and pussycat to be same. You may keep a pussycat on your lap, but you can't keep a tiger on the lap. It's a very dangerous creature. Similarly, Mayavadi. Okay, in the Mayavadi's body also there is soul. You respect him as a living entity. Even Prabhupada was walking in Chattikara in Vrindavan. On Mayavadi sannyasi was coming. So when Prabhupada looked at him, he folded his palm like this. And that sannyasi also folded palm and said, Namo Narayana, he said. And Prabhupada said, Hare Krishna. Krishna Imatirastu. Prabhupada also said. And Prabhupada told his disciples, even if you see Mayavadi Sannyasi, you should respect. It's not that you mistreat them or something. But the idea is, because they are atheistic, they are criticizing the form of the Lord, we don't associate with them. The spirit is that. That should be understood. Now, how many more questions now? Okay, I won't be able to answer now. It's getting late. I'm losing out time. So, I will answer them in the next week. You can cut and keep it for the next week. Possible, no? Okay. Sri Prabhupada.